We met at the usual spot. I was having a coffee at my favorite table on the right. Just staring at the table. I was stressed out, turning all the stuff in the same direction. I took a sip. They served me my donut. I ate it. Another 5 minutes passed. Finally, she arrived. She looked tired, but beautiful as ever. She pulled her chair just a little bit closer. She looked away. Not a good sign.
I don't think we should see each other anymore. I've decided to go away for a while.
I didn't know what to say. I just took another sip. I tried to touch her hand, but she pulled away. And then she was gone. I didn't know what to feel. I was driving to work. I turned off the radio. The music reminded me of her. I had to stay focused on the road. I stopped for a red light, and a beggar walked up to the car. I rolled down the window. I gave her a coin. The light turned green. I was already late. I had to hurry. Black smoke rose from the chimneys. I walked up to the front door. The doors were locked. I entered the code.
You are late. Come in.
I opened the doors. My boss tightened his tie. Hill, you are late. Go to your station. My boss pulled his helmet down. You are fired. Get your stuff. Thank you. I woke up in the afternoon again. I had no reason to get up. I was watching TV. She died. What happened to her?
Hello, Mr. Hill? Please open the door. Thank you.
Good afternoon, Mr. Hill. Our condolences for your loss. Please accept our gift.
The leaves were moving. Thank you.
Do you mind? Thank you. Please take my card. If you ever need any help, you can always call.
There I was, or at least what was left of me. I ordered another drink. The barman was a strange fellow. I took my wallet.
7, please. I don't have any change. There you go, sir. Bloody Mary.
I took a sip. He looked at me.
What do you have on your mind?
I took the photo out and unfolded it.
Women. Can't live with them,
can't live without them.
I put my glass down.
I have a solution, but it will cost you something. That would be 18. You know what to do, Mr. Hill.
A man was sitting next to me.
Hey man, do you have a light?
Here are some matches.
Thank you. Don't worry, I will find her.
I hesitated. Suddenly, the curtains opened. She started singing as loud as she could. Am I really doing this? bullet went straight through my head. But then I saw all my memories drifting by. The bouncer looked at me. His eyes widened.
Who are you?
I don't remember.
Very good. Come in.
The doors opened. It was hard to find familiar faces. I looked at the DJ. He took the record. He put the needle on. And it spun. A guy walked up to me.
Hey man. Enjoying the night? What do you have on your face? I can almost look through you.
What did he mean? I touched my face. I moved my finger to the hole. I felt again. And again. That guy. I remember him. I've met him before.
Lift your arms, please.
I was waiting for my interrogation. Someone opened the blinds. He looked at me, and then he closed the blinds again. The officer turned to me. He frowned.
What did you do to that poor woman?
A light flickered. He looked surprised.
What is wrong with you?
A darkness came over me. He was still looking.
I need your memory.
I touched the glass. And then I realized I lost it all. I was losing my mind. My soul was changing. But suddenly, a glimpse of recognition. She opened her eyes.
Head turned upside down.
Everything was changing. The moths flew into her eyes.
I wish we could go back to where it all started.
And she went up in the air, leaving me again.
Thank you.
I woke up in the street. I was looking at the sky. Clouds were drifting by. A shadow came over me. An old woman was standing next to me. She poked me with her stick.
You should call someone.
And she dropped a coin. I grabbed it. Slowly, I got up. There was only one place I could call. I walked to a phone booth. I put the coin in. I looked at the card and took the receiver. I dialed the number. 1, 3, 2. I listened.
Hello, Mr. Hill. We are expecting you. Please, wait for the car.
I put the phone down. A car arrived. I opened the door. The driver turned the mirror. For a moment, he looked at me. We drove to a large building with a white sign. I looked up. The white door. There was a man standing at the top of the stairs.
Mr. Hill, follow me. Please, sit down. Welcome to our institute. You have made the right choice. We are here to help you retrieve your lost memories and bring back color to your life. All you need to do is sign this paper. Please, sign here. Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Hill. Let's start with the first test. I will show you some items you might recognize. Move them to the right. 1. A donut. 2. A box. 3. A plant. 4. A photo. 5. A speaker box. 6. A coin. 7. A bird. Thank you. Now follow me. Please, meet Sarah. She is at the end of the hallway.
The lights went on, one by one.
Hi, Bob. Good to see you again. You almost remember it all now. Open the door and bring color to your life.
I was walking in the park. A woman sat on the bench. For a moment, I stopped to look at her. A bird flew away. She was drawing something. She put down her pencil. I asked her, "What are you drawing?" She looked down.
"It's a place I know,"
she said. She moved her hand and closed the book. "I'm sorry, it's gone now." She stared at me.
"No, it's not. It's all in your head."
She closed her eyes.